students, welcome to Eternal Easy Education. In this session, you are going to learn Chapter 3, Computer Organization. Content of this video is memory device, RAM and ROM. What is a memory device? A memory is just like a human brain. The computer memory is the storage space in the computer where data and instructions are stored. There are two types of accessing methods to access the memory, that means to read and write, to store and retrieve, that is read and write. So a place or the space where the content, data or the instructions are stored is said to be the memory. Then the accessing method is having two things. One is sequential access, another one is random access. In sequential access, the memory is accessed in an orderly manner from starting to end, in a sequential manner. Then random access. Random access, any byte of a memory can be accessed directly without navigating through the previous byte. So our data is stored in the memory, and the way how it is accessing is sequential and random. As it is random access memory, it is a quick to take the content. Then different memory devices are available. One is cache memory, another one is main memory, another one is hard disk. In this chapter you will learn all the things elaborately. Here there is a triangle representation of its capacity, speed and the rate, that means the cost. Hard disk is lowest cost, capacity is more, but the speed is less when compared with main memory. Main memory is costlier than hard disk. The storage is less than hard disk, but speed is more than the hard disk. Cache memory, the rate is very high, space is very small and the speed is very high. So there is a comparison in this. Let's see what is given in your book. Memory device. So it's a storage place. It is used to store data and instruction. Then this is the representation of the different storage devices. Here now we are going to see about RAM, that is random access memory. Another main memory is otherwise called random access memory. First point, this is available in computers in the form of integrated circuits. It is the place in computer where the operating system, application programs and the data in the current use are kept temporarily so that they can be accessed by the computer's processor. That means when you switch on the computer, you are waiting for the booting process, then you know the operating system which is stored in the hard disk is loaded in the RAM memory, main memory, that is the completion of booting. So after that, when we are opening a Word or anything, any application program, everything is maintained in the RAM memory. First point, RAM is otherwise called main memory, then it is a form of integrated circuits. Next point, when the power is on, the OS and all the running applications are using the RAM memory. The smallest unit of information that can be stored in a memory is called bit. So how the data are stored in the memory? In the form of bit. As you know, computer is a digitalized device. It will store the data only in the form of 0 and 1. In the previous video, you learned what is bit, what is byte, what is kilobyte, and there is a big tabular column for this. The memory can be accessed by the collection of 8 bits, which is called a byte. So the term byte is very important for computer science students. Then the RAM is a volatile memory. You learned this previously. Why it is volatile? The information stored in it is not permanent, so it is volatile. As soon as the power is turned off, whatever data and that resides in the RAM is lost. It allows both read and write. So random access memory allows read and write. So these are the main points of RAM. Then there are two types of RAM. One is dynamic RAM, another one is static RAM. These two types differ In technology, they used to hold the data. So the difference is in the technology, how they hold the data. Dynamic RAM being common type needs to be refreshed. Dynamic, from the word dynamic, you can remember the word refreshed frequently. Static RAM needs to be refreshed less often, which means it's faster. Hence, static RAM is more expensive. So which is more expensive? Static RAM is more expensive than dynamic RAM. So while you are buying the RAM, you can have an idea whether it is DRAM or SRAM. So this is the content regarding RAM. So random access memory, it can read and write. Then volatile, two types, static RAM, dynamic RAM. What about read only memory, ROM? Read only memory refers to special memory. It's a special memory in a computer with preloaded data at manufacturing time which cannot be modified. Underline it, pre-recorded data at manufacturing time which cannot be modified by the user who is buying that computer. The stored programs that starts the computer and perform diagnostics are available in ROMs. That is why booting BIOS, basic input output system, is stored in ROM only. That executes the content in the ROM. When the BIOS is over, it will take the OS from the hard disk to the RAM memory. ROM stores critical programs, such as program that boots the computer. Once the data has been written onto a ROM chip, it cannot be modified. So the data cannot be modified or reboot, can only be read. So only it is called read-only memory. ROM retains its contents even when the computer is turned off. So it is non-volatile. Why it is non-volatile? Because it stores the data even though there is no power. Then there are many types of ROM. One is programmable read-only memory, PRO. This is a old style of CD. Example, there are many things. The storage, one of the storage device which follow this methodology, programmable read-only memory, is CD. That is not the CD what you are using. In your age, you are not using program. It's a later version. It's a previous version. You will learn why it is previous. Programmable read-only memory is also a non-volatile memory on which the data can be written only once. Note the point. So it will be empty CD. Then you can store the data. After that, you cannot edit or delete. But nowadays, we are getting the CD which is read and write. So it's a programmable read-only memory storage device where it is empty and it can be written only once. Once a program has been written onto the ROM, it remains there forever. Unlike the main memory, ROMs retain their content even when the computer is turned off. That is non-volatile. The ROM differs from ROM. How it differs? The ROM is manufactured as blank. Yes, it is empty. Whereas ROM is programmed during the manufacturing process itself. So ROM programmable or a ROM burner is used to write data to a ROM chip. Nowadays we are not using any burners. That means it's a software, neuro software. There are many things, but here we are just inserting the CD, copy paste. We are doing very easily, but previously it's a CD burning technique. The process of programming a ROM is called burning the ROM. So this is the points regarding ROM. Then EPROM, erasable programmable read-only memory. Erasable, as the term erasable, only memory is a special type of memory which serves as ROM, but the content can be erased using ultraviolet rays. So EPROM can be erasable using ultraviolet rays. EPROM retains its contents until it is exposed to ultraviolet light. The ultraviolet light clears its contents, making it possible reprogram. Then, an EPROM differs from your PROM. PROM can be written only once. PROM can be written only once and cannot be erased. EPROMs are used widely in personal computers because they enable the manufacturer to change the content of the prompt to replace with updated versions or erase the content before the computer is delivered. Then, electrically erasable program, EEPRO, electrically erasable program, programmable read-only memory. This is erased by exposing it to an electric charge. Like other types of PROM, EEPROM retains its contents even when the power is turned off. Comparing with all other types of ROM, EEPROM is slower in performance. First point, electrically erasable. Second point, it is also non-volatile. Third point, the performance is slow. So, you have learnt what is RAM, what are the types of RAM, what is ROM and what are the types of ROM. So we'll see what is cache memory. Cache memory is the very high speed and expensive memory which is used to speed up the memory retrieval process. Due to its higher cost, CPU comes with smaller size of cache memory compared with size of main memory. Without cache memory, every time the CPU requests the data, it has to be fetched from the main memory, which will consume more time. That means there is a necessity for the CPU to take data frequently. So it is having this data in a cache memory, just like your pen. You can have your pen in your packet, so it is frequently used and your packet size is very small, so you are keeping only your pen. If it is a bag, its storage is more, but you will carry all your notebooks and textbook, but it is not used frequently. So you can have a frequently required data in a small memory space like cache memory. Without cache memory, every time CPU requests the data, it has to be fetched from main memory, which will consume more time. Think that your pen is in the pouch and the pouch is inside the bag. So every time you have to open the bag, every time you have to open the pouch, then you have to take the pen. Instead of, you can have your pen in your packet itself. Like that, the usage of cache memory. The idea of introducing a cache is that this extremely fast memory would store the data that is frequently. This fast memory would store the data that is frequently accessed, and if possible, the data that is closer to it. This helps to achieve the fast response time, where response time refers to how quickly the memory can respond to read-write request. So here there is a one mark, that is response time, or else it is access time, refers to how quickly the memory can respond to the read-write request. Here they are given CPU, cache memory, then main memory. So between the CPU and the main memory, there is an intermediate called cache memory. I hope this content will be very interesting and easy for you to learn. Have a recap. What is RAM? The main memory is otherwise called RAM. That is random access memory. It is volatile. And the two types are DRAM and SRAM. Then ROM, read-only memory, refers to special memory in a computer with the pre-recorded data at manufacturing time and it cannot be modified. So it is non-volatile memory. ROM, EEPROM, EEPROM. Then you have learned cache memory. That's all for this session, children. Learn well. Thank you. Have a good day.